Hello.
I've created this screencast to explain the principles of relative dating. This is figure 9.4 from your lab manual, and it shows a rather complex geologic cross-section. However, it is possible to sort out the relative age of each of the geologic strata or features. To do this, we're going to be historical geologists and use the principles of relative dating. These are described both in your textbook and lab manual. These principles include the principles of superposition, original horizontality, inclusion, lateral continuity, cross-cutting relationships, and faunal succession. However, not all of these will be used for this particular figure. I know that the figure looks complicated, but by using these principles, it will be quite simple to date the rocks and features relative to each other. That is, while an absolute date cannot be determined with the information given, it is quite possible to know which came first. So let's begin. I see that the vertical dikes here and here cut across all other rocks and structures. Thus, these are the youngest feature. Then I see that there are four horizontal layers at the top of the figure. So according to the principle of superposition, that says that younger rocks are deposited over older rocks, the rock unit at the top is the youngest, and the three below are successively older. So this would be the youngest, and this would be the oldest of these four rock units. Below these four rock units are an angular unconformity. That's indicated here with this line. Recall that an unconformity is missing time in the rock record. In this particular case, it is an angular unconformity because the rocks below were tilted. You can see these rocks that are tilted, then eroded, which led to the unconformity. And before the four topmost rock units were later deposited. But wait, I see that the igneous intrusions at the bottom, these here, cut across the tilted strata. So you can see it's cutting across the margins of this igneous intrusion, cut across the tilted strata. So according to the principle of cross-cutting relationships, this principle says that any feature which truncates or cuts another is the youngest. So according to the principle of cross-cutting relationships, these igneous intrusions have to be younger than these tilted strata. Then I see that there is a fault that here, right here, that also cuts across the tilted strata. However, it does not cut across either the unconformity here or the igneous intrusion here. Thus, the fault is younger than the unconformity and the tilted rock units, but younger than the igneous intrusion. So here's what happened. First, the rock formations below the unconformity here, these, were deposited. According to the principle of original horizontality, these were flat line when deposited. Then I know that through tectonic forces, these were then tilted or folded. At some point, these were faulted, because I see this fault is happened after these were deposited. But faulting happened before the magma was intruded that created these igneous intrusions. Then the tilted strata were uplifted and eroded. That's what happened here. Eventually subsided again, and these flat-lined sedimentary strata were deposited on top. The last thing that happened was the intrusion of the magma that created the dikes here. And I know that because these dikes cut across everything else. Complicated at first, but a fun puzzle using the principles of relative dating.